Hello students, myself Mr. Santosh Pawar welcomes you all in MGC Learning. Under the chapter Control and Coordination, today we are going to see our next topic, that is Hormones of Adenohypophysis, that is Hormones of Adenohypophysis. So student, our today's lecture content is Hormones of Adenohypophysis. As you know that adenohypophysis is the anterior lobe of a pituitary gland. This anterior lobe or the adenohypophysis, it secretes total 7 hormones. And the name of that 7 hormones are as follows. Number 1 TSH, number 2 FSH, number 3 ICSH, number 4 ACTH, number 5 LTH, number 6 GH, number 7 LH. I repeat the names of all the hormones once again. Number 1 TSH, number 2 FSH, number 3 ICSH, number 4 ACTH, number 5 LTH, number 6 GH, and number 7 LH. So all these are 7 hormones are secreted by the anterior lobe of a pituitary gland, that is adenohypophysis. We start with our first hormone, that is TSH. TSH, the full form of a TSH is thyroid stimulating hormone. T stands for thyroid, S stands for stimulating, and H stands for hormone. So thyroid stimulating hormone. So student, full form of a TSH is thyroid stimulating hormone. The function of a TSH, as it is secreted by the adenohypophysis, after this secretion, it is discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries the TSH towards its target organ, that is thyroid gland. So student, thyroid gland is the target organ of a TSH. It stimulates the thyroid gland, and due to stimulation, thyroid gland starts secreting another hormone which is called as a thyroxine. And student, you know that thyroxine is the main metabolic hormone. See the answer once again. See the flowchart first. Adenohypophysis secretes a TSH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. So TSH is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ. So the target organ of a TSH is a thyroid gland. It stimulates its target organ, means it stimulates the thyroid gland. And due to stimulation, thyroid gland starts secreting another hormone which is known as a thyroxine. So student, target organ of a TSH is a thyroid gland. TSH acts or the stimulates the thyroid gland, and due to stimulation, thyroid gland starts secreting another hormone called as a thyroxine. So this is the function of a TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. Let's start with the second hormone, FSH. F stands for follicle, S stands for stimulating, H stands for hormone. So follicle stimulating hormone. Student, it is one of the gonadotropic hormone. FSH is the one of the gonadotropic hormone, and its full form is follicle stimulating hormone. The function of FSH in a female. See the flowchart number 1. Adenohypophysis secretes FSH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its first target organ, and the first target organ of FSH is follicle cells of ovary. It stimulates the follicle cells of ovary, and due to stimulation, follicle cells of ovary secretes another hormone which is called as estrogen, and estrogen is the female sex hormone which is responsible for the secondary sexual characters in a female. I repeat this part once again. Adenohypophysis secretes FSH. As it is a hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ. Its first target organ is of follicle cells of ovary. It stimulates the follicle cells of ovary, and due to stimulation, follicle cells of ovary start secreting another hormone known as estrogen. Estrogen is also known as a female sex hormone. It is responsible for the secondary sexual characters in a female. Second function of FSH in a female. Adenohypophysis secretes FSH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its second target organ, which is nothing but the germinal epithelium of ovary. See, what is the germinal epithelium? Internally, ovary is lined by an epithelium. That epithelium is known as a germinal epithelium. It is the second target organ of FSH. So FSH stimulates germinal epithelium of ovary, and due to stimulation, germinal epithelium of ovary undergoes one process which is known as oogenesis. Which is known as oogenesis means formation of oocytes. Formation of oocyte. So this is the second function of FSH in a female. I repeat the second function once again. Adenohypophysis secretes FSH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its second target organ, that is germinal epithelium of ovary. FSH stimulates germinal epithelium of ovary, and due to stimulation, germinal epithelium of ovary undergoes the one process known as oogenesis. Student, this FSH, it also plays important role in a male. In male, this FSH, it stimulates germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubules of a testis. Let's see seminiferous tubule. Internally, each testis, or histologically, each testis is made up of number of microscopic tubules, and that tubules are known as a seminiferous tubule. Internally, this seminiferous tubule is lined by an epithelium which is known as a germinal epithelium. Student, in male, this FSH, it stimulates the germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubules of a testis, because germinal epithelium of a seminiferous tubules of testis is the target organ of FSH. So it stimulates it, and due to stimulation, germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubule of testes undergoes another process known as spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis means formation of sperms. In short, for the oogenesis and for the spermatogenesis, the hormone which is needed, it's nothing but the FSH. So in female, for the oogenesis, FSH is required, and in a male, for the spermatogenesis, FSH is required. Oogenesis means formation of oocyte. Spermatogenesis means formation of sperms. We start with our third hormone, that is ICSH. I stands for interstitial, C stands for cells, S for stimulating, and H for hormone. Interstitial cells stimulating hormone. I repeat, interstitial cells stimulating hormone. Again, it is one of the example of a gonadotropic hormone. So it is also one of the gonadotropic hormone. Let's see its function. See the flowchart. It is secreted by the adenohypophysis. So adenohypophysis secretes a ICSH. It is hormone, so it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ, and the target organ of ICSH is interstitial cells of testes. Interstitial cells of testes are the target organ of ICSH. It stimulates interstitial cells of testes, and due to stimulation, interstitial cells of testes start secreting another hormone known as testosterone, which is the male sex hormone, which is responsible for the secondary sexual characters in a male. I repeat this answer once again. Full form of ICSH is interstitial cell stimulating hormone. It is again one of the gonadotropic hormone. It is secreted by the adenohypophysis. So adenohypophysis secretes ICSH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ, that is interstitial cells of testes. It stimulates interstitial cells of testes, and due to stimulation, interstitial cells of testes start secreting another hormone known as testosterone, which is also known as a male sex hormone because it responsible for the secondary sexual characters in a male. This is about the third hormone, which is secreted by the adenohypophysis, and the name of that hormone is ICSH. Let's start with the fourth hormone, that is LH. L stands for luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone, L stands for luteinizing, H for hormone. Again, it is one of the gonadotropic hormone. Its function, student, the important function of LH is that LH carries out the process called as ovulation. Means the process of ovulation is under the control of a LH hormone, and ovulation means release of ovum from the mature graafian follicle. Ovulation means release of ovum, and this ovulation process is under the control of one hormone known as LH. Further, as you know that after the ovulation, the remaining part of graafian follicle, it becomes a shrink and it forms a yellowish mass, and the name of that yellowish mass structure is called as a corpus luteum, and this corpus luteum secretes one hormone known as a progesterone. So student, this LH, it also controls the secretion of a progesterone. Third function, this LH, it also controls the secretion of estrogen and the testosterone. These are the functions performed by the LH. LH, full form of LH, is a luteinizing hormone. It is one of the gonadotropic hormone. Its functions are as follows. Number one, process of ovulation is under the control of a LH hormone. Ovulation means release of ovum from the mature graafian follicle. Function number two, after the ovulation, remaining part of graafian follicle, it becomes a shrink and it forms a yellowish color mass. That mass is called as a corpus luteum, and this corpus luteum secretes one hormone known as a progesterone. So student, LH also controls the secretion of a progesterone. Third function, it also controls the secretion of two hormones, that is estrogen and the testosterone. So the secretion of estrogen, testosterone and the progesterone is under the control of a LH hormone, and it is responsible for the process known as ovulation. This is about our fourth hormone, that is LH. start with our fifth hormone, that is ACTH. A stands for adreno, C stands for cortico, T stands for tropic, and H stands for hormone. Adreno, cortico, tropic, hormone. So student, full form of ACTH is adreno cortico tropic hormone. Function of ACTH, see the flowchart. Adeno hypophysis secretes ACTH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ. The target organ of ACTH is cortex of adrenal gland. Cortex of adrenal gland is the target organ of ACTH. It stimulates the cortex of adrenal gland, and due to stimulation, cortex of adrenal gland starts secreting another hormones known as glucocorticoid, mineralocorticoid, and the androgen. So glucocorticoid, mineralocorticoid, and the androgen, these are the three hormones are secreted because of ACTH. I repeat, ACTH, full form of ACTH is adrenocorticotropic hormone. Function, see the flowchart. Adeno hypophysis secretes ACTH. As it is hormone, it is directly discharged into the bloodstream. Blood carries it towards its target organ. Target organ of ACTH is cortex of adrenal gland. It stimulates its target organ, and due to stimulation, cortex of adrenal gland starts secreting three hormones. Number one, glucocorticoid, mineralocorticoid, and the androgen. So student, for the secretion of glucocorticoid, mineralocorticoid, and the androgen, the hormone which is needed, nothing but the ACTH, which is secreted by the adenohypophysis of the pituitary gland. This is about the hormone number fifth, that is ACTH. Let's see number six hormone, that is GH. GH is also called as STH. Full form of GH is a growth hormone, and the full form of STH is somatotropic hormone. Somatotropic hormone. So student, another name for GH, it is also called as STH. Full form of GH is a growth hormone, and the full form of STH is a somatotropic hormone. As the word suggests you, growth hormone, that means the function of GH is it promotes the growth of bones and the muscles. It promotes the growth of bones and the muscles. Further, it also promotes the process of protein synthesis and the lipolysis in adipose tissue. It also promotes the process which is known as a protein synthesis, and it also promotes one process known as a lipolysis in adipose tissue. Students, lipolysis means the breakdown of lipids. Breakdown of lipids which is occur in adipose tissue. And for that, the hormone which is needed, the name of that hormone, it is known as a GH. The name of that hormone is known as a GH. I repeat, the function of GH, full form of GH is a growth hormone. Another name for GH is a STH. Full form of STH is a somatotropic hormone. Function of GH or STH, function number one, it promotes the growth of bones and the muscles. It promotes the growth of bones and the muscle. It promotes the protein synthesis. It also promotes the process known as lipolysis in adipose tissue. Lipolysis means breakdown of lipids in adipose tissue to release more fatty acid. So this is about the function of GH or STH hormone, which is responsible for the growth of bones and the muscles. Let's start with our last hormone, which is called as LTH or prolactin. LTH or the prolactin. The full form of LTH is luteotropic hormone. ल्यूटोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन, एल स्टैंड्स फॉर ल्यूटो, टी स्टैंड्स फॉर ल्यूटोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन, सो LTH ल्यूटोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ प्रोलैक्टिन. फंक्शन, द फंक्शंस ऑफ अ प्रोलैक्टिन और LTH. फर्स्ट फंक्शन, इट स्टिमुलेट्स द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मैमरी ग्लैंड. इट स्टिमुलेट्स द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ मैमरी ग्लैंड. सो स्टूडेंट, LTH इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ मैमोट्रोपिन. सो नेम मैमोट्रोपिन इज गिवन टू LTH बिकॉज इट स्टिमुलेट्स द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ मैमरी ग्लैंड. सो डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मैमरी ग्लैंड इज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ LTH. सो LTH इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ मैमोट्रोपिन. सेकेंड फंक्शन, इट इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द मिल्क सिक्रीशन बाय द मैमरी ग्लैंड. इट इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द मिल्क सिक्रीशन बाय द मैमरी ग्लैंड. सो LTH इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ लैक्टोजेनिक हॉर्मोन. सो लैक्टोजेनिक हॉर्मोन, द नेम इज गिवन टू LTH बिकॉज इट स्टिमुलेट्स द मैमरी ग्लैंड फॉर द मिल्क सिक्रीशन. सो मिल्क इज सिक्रीटेड आउट. So LTH is also known as a lactogenic hormone. Third function, student, LTH carries out the maintenance of a corpus luteum. It carries out the maintenance of a corpus luteum. So it is also known as a leutotropin hormone. So third name, that is leutotropin name, is given to LTH because it is responsible for the maintenance of a corpus luteum. And the fourth function, it reduces the chances of pregnancy during lactation period. Lactation period means milk secretion period is known as a lactation period. So during lactation period, LTH hormone reduces the chances of pregnancy. So these are the four functions performed by the LTH. Student, we will just revise the different names of the LTH first. LTH is also known as a prolactin. It is also known as a mammotropin. It is also known as a lactogenic hormone. It is also known as a luteotropin hormone. Why it is known as a mammotropin? Because it stimulates the development of mammary gland. So the name is mammotropin. The name lactogenic hormone is given because it stimulates the mammary gland for the milk secretion. So it is known as a lactogenic hormone. The name leutotropin is given because it is responsible for the maintenance of a corpus luteum. And the fourth important function, LTH or the prolactin, it reduces the chances of a pregnancy during the lactation period. So student, today we have seen the seven hormones of the adenohypophysis and the functions of it. Thank you so much.